Hey guys, this is StuMurray47 here, back with another Superman related review, and in today's video we're going to be looking at the fourth figure in the PlayArt's Kai Man of Steel line. We are of course looking at Faora Ul. Now, Square Enix, the company behind PlayArt's Kai, have not let me down so far in this series. Whilst I know there's been a lot of people who haven't been totally happy with the head sculpts and likenesses to the actual actors, you can't deny that they've definitely put the work in when it comes to sculpting. And when I saw the preview images for Faora, I could not wait to get her. Faora is a character in the movie, of course, that really, she kind of stole the show, as it were, especially in the Smallville fight. She is, of course, General Zod's right-hand man stroke woman. She's a real badass, she is an amazing warrior, and I love the design for the character. She was the one, I mean, anyone that's watched the making of the movies from the Blu-ray, which I know a lot of people might not already, but when you do watch them, she's probably the only Kryptonian that actually had a costume to wear. All the rest of them just wore sort of motion capture suits, where her costume was pretty much designed. So this is a very cool character. I loved the way that Antje Trau, the actress that portrayed her, I think she did a fantastic job, and once again, this was a figure I was really after. So, just taking a quick look at the packaging, of course, on the very front here, just like the Jor-El figure I recently reviewed, you can see it does include a pre-release image, of course, of the actual figure itself. The reason I say that is, of course, all these sections here, which look to be smooth, are of course textured in the final figure, but it's a really, really nice shot of the character, well, the figure I should say, with a planet in the background there with the sunrise, and of course you can see she's got her blade, which I think is one of her only accessories, and at the bottom there it says number 4, Faora Ul. Now on the side, it does of course have the usual Man of Steel logo with PlayArt's Kai. And on the back, we get some really beautiful images of what this figure has to offer. Just like Jor-El and, Jor-El and General Zod, she does, of course, have the removable cape with the back section which plugs in there. And they look like they've really recreated the costume very well. Of course, in the movie, she had the much higher collar on one side. The sort of jagged shoulder pieces. Just a very cool version of the character. Of course, at the very bottom there is a lot of language that I can't speak, of course, from Square Enix. It's basically just all the basic information. And at the bottom there, you can see there, 0 to 3, of course, no onion babies allowed. So, very important to note that. And basically, what we're going to do is just open the packaging up. Now, it does have a Velcro front cover here, just like the Jor-El figure that I recently reviewed. And on the inside, you can see the amazing figure. Now, I think this one is probably going to have the most lifelike face sculpt out of all of them. It really does look like Antje Trau, who played her. And you can basically she comes with two fists, she comes with her knife, her backpack, and she has probably one of the most interesting glyphs here on the bottom of the packaging. Now, I showed on the previous video, but all the characters have their own unique glyphs at the bottom of this packaging, which is see-through. Of course, Superman has his S, Jor-El has a slightly modified S with what looks like Krypton above it. General Zod, of course, has his symbol with the words Kneel right above it. And Faora has this. Now, this is, of course, her symbol, which we have seen on the Movie Master's base. And of course on her chest piece in the movie, on her Kryptonian armour. But I really love this kind of textured look around it, and there's kind of like lightning bolts coming off it, and it's a really sort of visually stunning, artistic sort of look at her logo there. I'm curious if this was shown anywhere else in the movie itself, but it's very cool. Now on the left hand side, we have another gorgeous picture of the figure, and it has a short read-up which basically says, Faora Ul is a genetically designed warrior, extremely talented with knives and hand-to-hand combat. Fiercely loyal to General Zod, she played a major role in the rebellion on Krypton and mutiny aboard the Black Zero. Although she appears savage and sadistic, her real desire is to do what she truly feels is best for the Kryptonian people. Her genetically imposed duty is to find a new Krypton, and she will stop anyone who gets in her way. I can't imagine a more apt write-up for the character if anyone's seen the movie. She really did put her planet first and was willing to pretty much sacrifice the entire human race. So anyway guys, that's been 4 minutes. I've still not opened the packaging, so I'm going to get to that as soon as, and we're going to take a look at Faora Ul out of packaging. Bear with me guys. I know you guys are going to get fed up of me saying this, but this is my new favourite in the line. It's funny, each time I open up one of these figures, there's so many cool things about them that you spend 5 minutes just looking at all the armour details. And Faora, out of all of them, has quite a few posing options. Such a unique sculpt. Of course, that's the great thing about Square Enix or PlayArt's Kai is this isn't Mattel. They're not going to reuse these body molds for anything else. These are unique to the movie, and Faora does not disappoint. Now, the face sculpt is probably the most accurate to the movie, and because of that, it's probably the one I would most recommend to fans of the film. I love them all, don't get me wrong, but if you're a big fan of Faora, you love the movie, you're going to love this figure. So I'm just going to go ahead and do a quick 360. And one of the things... just dropped one of her hands. One of the things I absolutely love is the cape. It's so long and sweeping, and I love the way it's kind of sculpted in this sideways kind of windblown pose. She is the most slight of all of them, as you can imagine. A lot of her limbs do feel a little frail, and because of that, I'm not going to push them to their limits. I've heard some horror stories of people kind of moving their PlayArt's Kai arms and them just dropping off, and I do not want it to happen with this one. However, hot water, a hairdryer will certainly loosen up the figure if you want to, but look how cool and how majestic she looks. They really have recreated the suit to perfection. Of course, there is one minor nitpick from the set, and I will mention it later. It's actually just about, once again, her posability options. But I just wanted to show just how dynamic and how cool she looks just in profile there. So what I'm going to do is I'll stop her rotating just now, bouncing the camera around, and I'm going to show you her in a bit closer detail. As I said, she probably has the most movie-accurate look when she's in focus. Whoa. Look at that, how cool. Once again, they've done a really good job of recreating a lot of the aspects of the suit. I mean, just like General Zod's, the armour, the Kryptonian armour, is of course black, but it's got a beautiful silver dry brushing going all the way through it. Her face sculpt, if I can get this to zoom even just a bit closer, is really beautiful. The eyes are well painted, she looks quite imposing, you know, there's no smile on this face. And the way they've done her hair is very nice because it's actually two-tone. I'm sure this will show up, but it's a light grey colour, but the tips are all kind of a darker black colour. And I think that might be movie accurate. I can't 100% remember just offhand, but I do really like the face sculpt. And certainly anyone that bought the Movie Masters figure, you know, this is a slight improvement on that. Obviously, I'll compare it later. But just going down through the costume, as I was saying before, of course, this is very movie accurate. The fact that she has a much higher sort of neck guard here. But I just love the sculpting. Of course, that can be removed. But just going down through the suit here, as I said, the silver dry brushing looks fantastic here. So beautifully sculpted. And of course, here's her breather mask. Now, unlike General Zod, this one doesn't come out. Of course, in the movie, this section actually goes up to her nose and her mouth. And then, of course, the transparent breather dome appears. I might as well mention it now. That's my one disappointment from the set. And I love this one. But she should have come with a breather alternate head. General Zod did. Now, admittedly, his was all black. And it wasn't the transparent. But I am sure, given today's technology, they could have basically just created this head sculpt but put like a resin over the front of it and scribed the lines. And I think that would have been possible. That's my only gripe. And by all means, it is not a criticism of the figure. It's more of an omission, which I really wish they'd had. However, moving down through the suit, you can see, as I was saying before, she has the suit texture going all the way through her midriff and her wrists and crotch and legs, matching Superman's. Essentially, it is the Kryptonian bodysuit, I think, as they called it on set. But you can see here she has the same suit piping as Superman does and Jor-El does. And I love the way it's just kind of poking out there. Her suit is beautiful. I know I've mentioned it a couple of times already, but just looking at the dry brushing continues all the way through the elbow pieces, the gauntlets, and this is a good touch. She has the same kind of wrist guards or wrist gauntlet looking things that Superman does, which is very cool. Now, an extra addition she has that no one else does, she actually has a rubber blade sheath, obviously, for one of her very few accessories. I'll get to that in a minute, but her blade sheath obviously just sits very coolly. It's actually glued in at the front and the back there, so it does not remove, but the blade does. So I think that's a very nice touch. Continuing down through the body, as I said, silver dry brushing, beautifully sculpted you know, just armor pieces. I love, I mean, this was one of the funny things about this. Of course, they're super powered on Earth, but if they weren't, a lot of Faora is exposed. You know, if this was just a general military suit, I've, I always thought this was quite funny. If you look at her boots, the fronts of her shins are exposed, which is probably not a good idea if you're a warrior. However, it looks fantastic. I even love these kind of, these sections here, like suits of armor, you know, the segmented sections. She has those, of course, similar things in her arms as well. But going down to her boots, and this is movie accurate as well, she was wearing quite high platforms to make her a little taller. And these are kind of funny, but they look pretty cool as well. I love that they've kind of got segmented sections on the rear as well. So everything looks really functional in the figure. There's no peg holes. But yeah, she's absolutely fantastic. So, I mean, this is the front of the suit, and it does not disappoint. Even, I didn't mention this before, but the gloves, look at that, just brilliant. The amount of sculpting they put, and of course she comes with two alternate sets of hands. Beautiful. So on the back, basically her armour, of course, continues. Once again, silver dry brushing. It really does make it stand out into the eye. It glistens in the light. I don't know if it's doing it on camera. In fact, it looks like it is, but it really does glisten in the light. Now her cape, whilst it looks like it's attached here and here, technically the entire back section removes, but I'm just going to show you the cape itself. Now, just like General Zod's, it is mainly black. There are silver elements, and there's a very, very subtle kind of a greeny colour. It's very hard to make out. I don't know if it's showing up on camera. But the cape is quite pliable. You know, it will move up and down. It's not perfectly rubberized or anything. It's not going to fold in on itself, but it does... It does sort of, is quite pliable, I should say. What I'm going to do is I'll just remove the back section. Now, to do that, what you actually have to do is take off this part first. So this shoulder piece just pulls off, and you can see there's just a few clips here. There's a long clip here, and there's a little single clip, and they basically just go in this section, and there's a hole here. So basically, I'll just put that down for a second. The cape and back section, if you just kind of take a grip of it, I don't know if I can do this on camera, just give it a pull and it just comes off. So you can see here she's got a pretty big plug in her back, she has two plugs up on her shoulders, and finally she has two circular plugs here and here. So the back section is, you know, pretty solid when you put it in. So I'll just put her out of the way and I'll just show you the cape in a bit more detail. As I said, this is more like a backpack really. You can see all the attachment parts, and there's the hole for the shoulder piece. So it's very well made. As I said, it's quite rubbery, quite pliable, so it's not really going to hinder articulation or you know, any sort of dramatic posing. But I love the way it's kind of just swept off to one side. Very, very cool. You can see a bit more of the green there, I think, just in the recesses. Very nice. So, obviously, she has a big gap in her back, but while I've got the back removed, I'm just going to take the advantage to show you some more of the sculpting. Don't look at her butt. but it's very, very nice. She has the same lines going up her leg, once again, that Superman does. And the same suit piping around the waist. Very, very cool. I love how slender her waist is as well. It's a really, really slender waist. You know, if you see it from the front there. It gives her a, you know, a kind of a triangular shaped armour there. Of course, she looks quite cool without the taller armour piece as well, but it's good to know that you can take the back off. Anyway, what replaces the cape is this section here, which essentially just plugs into the gap. Now, one interesting thing, I'm just going to go ahead and plug it in just now. I'll just show you me putting it in. It just goes like this. And you give it a good push and it clips in. And there she is without her cape. So, of course, she looked like this for quite a bit of the film. Obviously, after the Smallville fight, she kind of, I think she lost her cape. The strange thing is, she has a gap in her back here, which looks like it's designed for something else to go into, but there is nothing else in the packaging. Now, I checked the instructions. There are instructions for her knife, to remove her hands, how to build the base, how to take the back off. Nothing about anything going in here, so I don't know if this is just movie accurate. If she just had a big hole in her back, but it seems a bit strange that that would be there. Anyway, I don't remember there being a gap in the movie. But onto the figure itself, I'll just attach her shoulder piece just so that she's... And this, once again, you see here, it's just got like a... If I can get this right. Yeah, there we go. So it just kind of clips in here. Oh, it's a nightmare doing it on camera. This clips in and that pushes down. So basically, here we have her, obviously, in her uncaped look. Very, very cool. I'm just about to go into articulation, guys, if you bear with me. Yet again, another figure in the line that doesn't disappoint for articulation. There are a few areas that I am going to push very much in the arms, for example. They do seem very, very stiff, and I don't want to risk it without hot water or a hairdryer. But starting from the top down, her head is really articulated, so it will actually do a full three... Well, it'll do as much as you need it to do and still keep her alive. It is on a very good ball joint, so it will actually rock side to side very, very far. You know, there's a lot of movement there. It will also look pretty much all the way down, so her nose is almost touching there, and it doesn't look so far back, but it's not because of the ball joint, it's because of her raised collar here. There's just only so far back that she can put her head, but overall, you know, that's a vast amount of articulation. You know, you'll be able to get some really good poses looking all the way down, looking reasonably far up. Obviously, if you arch the waist, you know, she can look quite far up, but very, very nice head articulation. Now, I've already showed you that this shoulder piece actually removes. However, this one here is actually on a ball joint in here. I don't know if you can actually see it or not, but there is actually a ball joint there which allows it to rotate this way, so it does sort of a lateral movement. It will also do up and down, so of course she can get her arms up. Now, speaking of the arms, I'll start, there is an inner joint back here, just like the other figures, and what that allows for, if I can get her into focus, is that allows the arm socket to go forward really far and go back in really far. I'll show you it from this angle. You know, it will actually come all the way out. Now, I know it looks kind of inhuman the way it's doing that, but it does really allow for some really good posing, so you can see that the vast amount of movement that's got there. Now, her arm will go forward and back. Now, it is meant to go out and in. For example, you can actually see there is a very out of focus shot here. There is actually a hinge joint in here. However, I'm only getting a tiny bit of movement. And you know what? It just feels really brittle because her arms are so thin. I'm not really going to mess with this yet until I heat it up. But it is meant to go out 45 degrees. I have seen images where it'll do that. This one on this side's a bit more free. As I said, I'm not going to mess with this one until I kind of unfreeze it with heat there. But moving on to the arms, it also has a bicep rotation, or she also has a bicep rotation, which is very, very cool. She has a ball joint on her elbow here, which allows the arms to kind of click forward. They do click really quite far. Now, I think they'll also click slightly far back as well. Of course, the elbow pad here stops it, but quite a good bit of motion there. In addition to that, her arms do rotate at this ball joint here. So she has a rotation at the bicep and at the sort of elbow joint here. Not only that, but it rotates on the bottom. You can obviously rotate the ball joint inside the socket as well, so that's very cool. And regarding her fingers, of course, the wrists are removable, so of course the replacements will actually do a full 360, and they do bend quite far in and quite far out, kind of spidey whipping pose there. So very, very articulated arms. As I said, I'm looking forward to unfreezing this joint. Now, regarding her torso, just like Jor-El, Superman, of course, General Zod, she has basically two ball joints, one kind of here, like in the sort of sternum area, and one at the waist. So it will allow her to do a full rotation here. Very, very nice. As I said, it's really, really great articulation here, and you can see from this pose that she will arch her back quite far, and at the bottom here she has another ball joint, and this of course rotates. It's quite tight, but this one rotates as well, so you can obviously twist her waist, and it does go forward and really far back. Look at that. It was kind of frozen there before, but I've now unlocked it. Look at that. She really does arch her back much more than the other figures, and she will go forward quite far as well. So that's got a lot of articulation. She's really quite nimble. And very apt to the character. You know, of course, she was quite athletic, jumping all over the place. Now, lower articulation, just like all the other figures, this piece here is rubber. So this piece isn't plastic at all, including her butt here. So you can actually see it covers a lot of the articulation. Now, what the legs have is the legs will actually go forward. Now, it sounds like they're going to break, but it's just on a really clicky joint. So they will go forward quite far. They do go reasonably far back. I can get it in focus. Yeah, reasonably far back, reasonably far forward. They will also, and I'll show you this here, they actually do have a crotch joint. You can see the joint in there. So I'm not going to push it, but they do actually, they will potentially go quite far out in the splits there. And all you need to do is whenever you get in a pose that you're happy with, you just readjust the crotch there just to cover any gaps, you know, or as much as possible. And it also, in addition to moving out forward left, these legs have a rotation. I'll try and get this. Sorry, guys, it's hard to keep this in focus. It's so big. Yeah, so you can see here, in addition to going forward, left, right, it also does a rotation in the socket there, which kind of you can obviously turn it to hide that exposed part. Now, there's no thigh rotation or anything like that, but she has an amazing double knee. What happens here, obviously, is you can bend at this, and then if you keep bending, it will bend all the way back so that her heel is great. So that's a really good piece of articulation. It does look a little bit funky here, but of course this knee pad does hide it quite well. And it also does, for some reason, bend forward as well. There's a leg break for you. That's quite funny. But as I said, great articulation in the legs there. Now finally, going down to the feet, much better than Jor-El's. They do actually go quite far down, so they will tip like that. They do actually go reasonably far up. Now they will rotate, and they also have an amazing ankle pivot. Now, it's actually better on this one to show you. It will actually pivot all the way there, all the way in. You know, so obviously a lot of dynamic posing going to be available for this figure. So, once again, fantastic articulation, beautiful sculpt. How cool is this figure? Now, I've not even mentioned the other accessories. So, she also comes with her blade, which she featured in the Smallville fight. When Colonel Hardy was kind of using his machine gun, using his pistol, and then he pulled his knife and she pulled hers. And it's very well sculpted. It's just in her sheath here. So you just slide it out. And I don't know how well this is going to show up, but it's got a very nice purple handle. If you bear with me. Yeah, I knew this was going to be a nightmare trying to focus. If you wait a minute. There we go. So yeah, it's a really nice purple handle there, very well sculpted. Once again, it has the bone motif. You can tell it's from Krypton, because it has that kind of bone motif. But yeah, very, very cool little blade there. Looks quite sharp. I love the silver edge there. Once again, it's got a bit of silver dry brushing on it, in addition to this really intricate paintwork. Very nice. And of course, she does come with two alternate sets of hands. She has the fist on for the left hand here. She has the knife-holding hand for the right. And the alternatives, or the alternate versions, you just have an open, relaxed hand here. And you have an open, relaxed hand here. So this was these are the ones that come in packaging, the open, relaxed ones. But I figured that I'd prefer the fist and the knife-holding hand. So the knife itself does go quite well into the hand. I'm just going to get this done. Yeah, you can see this. So the knife does go very well into the hand. It is held in there securely, and obviously, it'll allow you to get that, but allow you to drop the knife yet again, if you bear with me. A close-up really does kind of show the differences here between the companies. Square Enix completely, you know, they completely nailed it with this. It's absolutely fantastic. And the Mattel one, oh, I don't know. I mean, I must admit, I was, as I said before, I was an apologist for it before, but there's just, there's no comparison here. This one is really pretty and well-toned, and this one just has a really big jaw. You know, I wish I had a jaw that big. So anyway, of course, you can see they're definitely the same character. And you know that the sculpting is pretty similar here. Well, I say it's pretty similar. You know, you, the broad strokes are the same. But just the sheer amount of paint detail in this really does set it apart from the Mattel one. And last but not least, I just want to compare it to the iconic statue. DC Collectibles. And I think you'll agree that hands down it wins the contest. It looks just like it. Okay, it's a statue, but it's not really that much larger than the head sculpt for the PlayArt's Kai one. As much as I love it, the statue wins hands down. I mean, the sheer detail is just brilliant. Okay, once again, just a very brief comparison. I just thought I'd show you the three stages of Faora there. Pick whichever one you prefer. Definitely this one. In closing, guys, here is the entire series of PlayArt's Kai figures. Of course, you've got Superman, Faora, General Zod, and Jor-El. I must admit, and you know me, massive Superman fan, Superman is probably my least favourite. I do love it, I love the paint apps, and I do like the cape and the way the costume's made, but there's just so many intricate sculpting choices with Faora, General Zod and Jor-El that he really is probably my fourth favourite. It probably goes, at the moment, even though I said Faora was the best, I think it's probably Jor-El, then Faora, then General Zod, and then Superman. But this is a must-buy line. I know most of you have kind of commented already about not liking the head sculpts, etc. But I really do think you should take a chance on this line. You will not be disappointed. They look fantastic on a shelf, as you can see here. Certainly, Jor-El and Faora look amazing. Anyway, guys, I'll leave it there. Sorry I've kept this so long. Thanks for watching, and I really appreciate reading all your comments, and I look forward to seeing you guys on the next review. Are you going to buy any of these, guys? Are you going to just leave them, or are these going to be on your Christmas list? I'd love to know, and I'll see you guys on the next review. Take care, guys. Bye.